This is Kereznikov.
You can hear me, right?
Don't you believe me? He's moving! Cover! My cover!
Feet is louder than you. Okay.
Back the wall! Go get him!
Can't see shit!
Expecting.
Oh, who's your fucking partner?
Got none to fucking you!
Alright, there we go. That should be a little bit better. I can't wait to see it on 4K video.
Layout shows only one room left, the bathroom. Go.
Sure hope our target's in there. Cabrones.
Think I got her. Got our target.
We make it? She alive?
This does not look good.
No, in a minute. Jacking into Biomon.
Biomon.
Sandra Dorset, NC570442. Got a winner. Well, she will be if we can get her to a hospital. Sheesh. Trauma Team Platinum, too.
Platinum? Shit. TT should have swooped in if she sneezed.
Something's jamming the Biomon signal. Talk to me, T-Bug.
Virus, probably. Locator neurosocket. Should be a shot.
Alright, here we go.
Probably on that. If we clear it, free up the signal, TT could actually drop in. Take her off our hands.
Got the shard. Removing it now. Done.
And it's really scary because shit like this isn't far off.
Biomon claims trauma will be here in 3 minutes.
I mean, all it takes is one breakthrough in cybernetics to get this way. I mean, we already have state-of-the-art appendages for people that need them. And there we go, there's your booby shot.
Mierda, she's flatlining!
V, you need to know what's going on.
Jackie, air hypo!
Care, China!
She's stable.
Fuera, China. Get her outside. I'll cover you.
It turns out a virus disrupted the girl's locator implant. We fixed that, and now help is inbound.
Swarm of the sons of bitches, two vans full, just pulled up outside.
Fuera, get her out, terrorists!
Stand clear, landing! Stop where you are!
So, for what you saw, Go Magician, are you leaning on the side of getting the game?
5 steps back, now! I said, step back!
TT-133 to control. Patient NC570442 secured. Stimulants being administered. 70 milligrams dopamine, 110 norepinephrine, 800 vibrant.
Hey, give us a lift out of here.
Plus boobs. Well, this is the cool thing that people don't realize. They're going to do multiplayer. I don't know if it's going to be in the game from the get-go, but for what people are saying, it's going to be like
that was trauma
GTA 5 online on steroids. You know, so much more to do. A bigger world.
We've delivered the target, and T-Bug has notified us that the scavengers have called in reinforcements.
So, yeah, that...
Let's get out of here before they arrive.
I got the eddies for
there's that.
Buying something real fine, too.
And the single player is going to be huge.
All on booze in 3 days.
Talking about somebody else, Jack.
Chicka bow, chicka bow wow, chicka chicka bow wow. Full moon rising there for you, Goad. You just got a face full.
Cyberpunk is a mature,
side boob,
visceral experience, and as such, it will let you explore a variety of different interactions with the game world, and as you just saw, its people.
Hello, Night City. You may stand here with a team sheet of all last night's biz. But first member of the band, the myth, Johnny Silverhand, been a year since he went on his last ride. All you gunks sitting in the afterlife, nursing that scotch, waiting for something better. You know what I mean.
The job was a success, and V obviously has some money to burn.
She, it's a created character by you. You can do whatever you want. You see her eyes glow.
Pull some pants on your culo and get down here. Subway entrance. Bring your iron.
Okay.
This song is awesome.
Just told us that he has some big news for us. And we have an appointment with our Ripper Doc today. Before we leave, let's take a good look around our apartment. Good morning, Night City. The song on the radio is by rocker boy Johnny Silverhand.
Rocker boy.
It's part of our creative process to draw inspiration from the pen and paper system created by Mike Pondsmith. And to put our own 27.
So I know what the song is.
Let's go grab our gear.
Look, I said this. There's swords. There's fucking swords. Okay. So samurai swords, but you
we'll
can play.
Take this trusty pistol.
Hopefully with swords. And notice they didn't show you everything. So you just get a glimpse of swords.
Since Cyberpunk 2077 is an RPG, the jacket not only provides us with protective.
This part right
armor,
here.
But it also increases our street cred. Street cred is a form of experience the player acquires.
Pretty sure you can pick all those jackets.
It is
jackets.
Used to unlock new vendors and content throughout Night City. All right, let's go meet Jack. V's current apartment is located inside a mega building, a huge building complex that forms a micro society of its own. In this timeline, technology and the world have evolved in some ways that seem familiar, but entirely surprising in others. As an example, in this world, people
it's
pay with
amazing
slang for Euro dollars.
It so reminds me of
we
the Judge Dredd.
Every detail in the
Mega Blocks.
Lore, so everything has its purpose.
Welcome to the stream, everybody.
A big part of our RPG experience is having a world that is interactive. Here, a generic ad has morphed into an advertisement specifically tailored to V, informing her of the nearest vendor she can purchase the product. In this case, it shows us where to find some Nicola soda.
Try out our pressure for a tank and let your tongue be amazed. Yum.
Cowboy.
Hey, you're all 45. It's ready.
This is Wilson, one of Night City's many gunsmiths. We won't be checking his wares today.
Who does
but you can purchase and upgrade your weapons and gear throughout the city.
Later, then.
Cyberpunk 2077 is set in Night City. Really? A bustling metropolis located on the coast of the free state of North California. It's a dystopian city where violence and oppression are the norm. We are working hard to make Night City a fully realized, seamless open world with no loading screens.
Currently, God damn!
Watson, a former industrial district where crime now mixes with money.
Very strong signal. You kidding me? Damn signal gonked out three times.
I just hope that all these vendors you see, all these restaurants or whatever the hell they are, I hope you can go to all of them and it's not a facade. Like, all these little areas should allow you to buy something, whether it's food, ammo, guns, armor. Not just placeholders. And then this right here. I mean, come on, look at this shit.
We've greatly enhanced our crowd and community systems to create the most believable city in any open-world game to date. The
Man.
Streets are bustling with crowds of people from all facets of life, all living their lives within a full day and night cycle.
Man, this shit in VR right here would be fucking mind-blowing. I don't know if it's gonna have VR support on computer or anything, but if it doesn't, someone's gonna mod the shit. It's in first person.
Okay, there's Jackie.
Fucking finally.
Buckle up. Shit's happening.
What's up, Jack?
Dexter Deshawn. Huh? Sound familiar? Wonder wants to talk to you. What a Night City.
I wish I would have did this while the game was being shown, but
need to walk on over there and get us a job.
It was already late into the stream, and it was like, eh, I'm not gonna rush to try to get it up.
Fine, I'll meet him. Talk.
Plus, I wanted a better quality.
It turns out we've caught the attention of one of Night City's biggest players, Dexter Deshawn, a fixer.
This is still off a stream. It's not a true 1080p signal, but
discuss a job.
Get it.
Let's see what he has for us.
Yo. Miss V, a pleasure. Let's roll. Scanning a serious job just now. Playing gargantuan compared to smashing up a scared home.
I'm gonna go close my door. I'll be right back.
Interested, Sherry. Tell me more.
Well, glad to hear it. Before we can start in on this, though, I need to be sure. Sure you all right.
All right. And the nature of this test?
Slot in the show. See, got a classic tale for you. Psycho Gang, just doing his thing, jumped a corp convoy, got away with gear. Now I need me that little combat bot. They call it the Flathead. Of course, I got the eddies to buy it, but me and the Maelstrom boys ain't the best of friends. No flow to our convo, see?
Who's the woman?
Corpo agent. She's on the hunt for the dogs who sold the Gangoon Jinfa to the convo.
Okay.
Her chief suspect, most likely. Going on 20 hours since the convoy was jumped, and she still don't have no guilty body. Gotta be desperate by now. Be wise to think how you could use that. Got any questions for me?
Clear on it all, I think. Time I got to work.
Beautiful. Here's hoping my inkling checks out.
So,
hope everyone else is excited about this game as much as I am.
And this will be the start of a beautiful friendship based on heaps of evidence.
It seems Dexter has given us a test of sorts to see if we're worthy. He wants us to retrieve a piece of high-tech combat gear a local gang stole from the Militech Megacorp. We'll be able to approach this job from a variety of angles. Let's try calling the Militech contact to see where that leads. 10, 100
times what I can take. Stout here. Hi. Heard you were looking for some tech. Let's talk.
Hey, everybody, shut it! Where is it? Come on, spill.
On the horn? No.
Amateur hour. Jesus. First exit off Skyline, going towards the NID. Storm channel under the overpass. Meet you there.
The situation's tricky because the contract giver is a corporate agent who seems a little high-strung. Before we get down to business, it's a great idea to visit our Ripper dock.
I think currently the Xbox One X and the PlayStation Pro could run this game fairly well. It doesn't look overly graphical. I mean, it has some really nice aesthetics,
Night City is
but
not a
nothing
safe place.
Too overwhelming.
Is not easy.
Now, with the amount of people, but they're just walking around. There's no special particle effects. There is lighting, but there's nothing crazy about the lighting.
V.
Hi there, Game Boy.
It's all here.
All right, I'll check it out while I wait for you.
Thanks for tuning in, buddy. This fucking game's awesome. No, I'm not playing it. We're watching a gameplay. I wish I was playing it.
We're at a Ripper Doc clinic. Ripper Docs are specialist vendors who offer people the possibility to install or upgrade their cyber.
Vicky, spry as ever, you old Ripper.
Hey, Vicky.
Thanks. Need to bump up my specs and get a grip.
God, this is fucking amazing.
Now.
Welcome to the stream, everybody.
Shit just got real.
I'll be quiet, man.
Got a job from Dexter Deshaun.
Spunky monkey.
The Dexter Deshaun? Yeah, that is something. But let me guess. Hasn't paid you yet.
Quit crying, Vic. I'll bring you the Eddies later. With interest. You know I will.
Oh, shit.
I swear. Now sit.
25 cents.
Now, jack in.
I should actually turn the alerts off for this because I wanted to upload this to YouTube.
We're going to install both an optical scanner.
Mark one, it's all right, though.
Decent enough scanner. Displays data on your cornea.
And a subdermal weapon grip.
Link's not labeled.
God!
To be perfectly honest, yeah. I'm not entirely sure where the hell I got it. Still, looks like it'll talk to Kiroshi Tech.
I'm ready.
Oh, no, no buffer, no buffer. No, bad buffer.
Okay, all clean. Now for the fun stuff. Lay that Major League arm of yours.
Foam Android? Here.
Just like that. Thanks. Now a bit of
anesthetic. Oh, Tom Arnold. Why didn't you say Tom Arnold for?
Feel anything?
Oh, it looks like Tom Arnold. Well, I guess so.
Doc. Play by play. Makes you sound like a dentist. You're always going on and on.
Don't be mean now. Remember, I'm old. I got a shaky ganic hand.
So Game Boy, what do you think so far?
Lights out for a minute, all right? Good. So let's test it. Linking you in. You might feel a little discomfort.
And now the tentacles come in to fuck you.
How's it look to you?
They have biometric augments on their arms and legs, but they have no cure for baldness. He has a bald patch.
This is fantastic.
Beautiful. Time for the scanner.
Additionally, we can analyze objects, get details on enemy weak points or gang affiliation.
It might take you a while to adjust, but first time's really the charm with anything. Scanner should eventually sync with your thought processes, read your intentions.
How you been, Gold? No, not Gold, sorry. Game Boy.
You should see your ammo count in a brand new sight.
The subdermal weapon grip links to our scanner and shows us weapon information like ammo count and fire modes. It also increases the base damage on all connected weapons.
Shit, Victor. Not bad. I don't know what to say.
Say you'll take this and remember the dosage. Two whiffs now, and another two in an hour.
Thanks again. You're the best, Vic.
Go on, kid. Show them what you can do. And once you hit the big time, don't forget where you came from.
I think Game Boy is just entrancing the game. He's not saying anything.
While some Ripper docks operate legally, others provide black market services. For the right price, they can even offer to install illegal military-grade cyberware.
Left a few minutes ago. Said he'd wait outside.
It's Harley. No, not really.
Well, well. Hiroshi. Old Vic's got a soft spot for you, Haina. Come on. How about you use them fancy-ass optics to scan my new wheels?
Sure. But you'll have to let me take it for a spin.
Hey, just watch the paint job.
Just watch the paint job.
This pendejo.
Hey, carnal! Hey, you got a problem?
This guy looks an awful lot like one of those scavengers we took out earlier.
Something tells me that wasn't no coincidence, huh?
Jackie's car is a super-powered sports car running on Chew 2, the super fuel of the future.
Chew 2.
Players can explore Night City freely.
God damn, cars, man. Just on bikes, fucking look at that.
This does not look good.
Puta madre!
Grab the wheel, Jack!
It looks like the scavengers from earlier are still angry.
They're pulling ahead, Haina. Watch it now. Got
it. He just ran him over.
I think we got rid of him. That was intense.
Shit! The fuck was that?
Night City never sleeps. Danger lurks around every corner, even.
This is the only part of first person VR. Wouldn't it be good?
Of how your actions directly influence your open world experience.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Okay,
first Jackie. Person in the car.
So, they're
scavs?
you little fucking teddy bear.
Should be looking for a new spot to slice and dice, not gunning after us. But who knows? Real messed up pendejos, guys. Saw it yourself.
Many forces are fighting for control of Night City, but the mega corporations are the real showrunner. The agent we're going to meet represents Militech, one of the largest companies in the private military sector.
Why are we stopping?
Sorry about that. If the screen popped up there, I was trying to open for some other reason.
Remember the corpo off Dex's shard? Ringer, she's in the area and looking at me.
Let me guess. She's in hot corporal water. Desperate. Then you think you can use that.
See if I can, yeah.
Since Cyberpunk 2077 is an RPG, preparation will be key when dealing with Night City's powerful. Especially when these are corpos. Instead of just rushing in, let's assess the situation with our freshly installed Kiroshi optical scanner.
They did well, it was when it goes third person, like if you want to do third person driving. You didn't see a edge window pop up on stream, did you? Or did you? I wasn't sure because I didn't see it on my end. Because I was trying to move it over.
Yeah, gotta do this. Don't you move a damn muscle. Not unless I start, that is.
There was some of this that I missed as well, so I did want to watch it again.
These guys are levels higher than we are. Let's try to approach them carefully.
Stout, take it you were the one to call?
Yep.
You wanted... Think you're smart? Thought you could blackmail me, bitch? Conditions?
Calm the hell down.
She didn't try to blackmail you.
Now, asshole.
You're insane. Who the fuck is this?
I'll know in 2 seconds flat. That fucking thing ready?
All set.
Are you here alone?
The Corpos have hacked us through our personal link and have subjected us to a kind of lie detector program. The dialogue system in Cyberpunk 2077 is fully gameplay driven.
I asked if you came.
Oh, you see the little fins in his eyes.
Yep.
Scanning.
Just little old me.
She's lying.
Search the area. Now listen, we don't need to be here all day. This piece of shit, Anthony Gilchrist, did he or another asshole at Militech leak info to you or
hang
anyone
now
else about a car?
Hurt like a bitch.
It might be tempting to reach for the gun, but the consequences
got
could be dire.
To do with him.
Remember,
or Militech.
These guys are really tough.
Shit. Checks out.
You got nothing on me. Nothing. Won't get away with this, you bitch. You're dead.
Somebody shut him up.
Take me home. Now.
All right. I have no idea who you're working for or what you even want, but you better give me something solid or I will end you.
I've got an offer.
Oh, you are stretching. This better be fucking good.
Gang goons who ripped you off? I know where to find them. They got a bot I want. Give me the funds to buy that bot. You can do what you want with the gang.
I don't give a shit about the thieves. I want my mold. Cred chip, 50k. Just enough to buy you your bot. Thing is, Chip's gotta make it into the thieves' terminal. That's all I need. Think you can do that? Then we got a deal.
Fine. I'm in.
Try to fuck me in any way, and I'll be seeing you.
No, she is gonna fuck you.
You're making a mistake! This cunt's good as dead!
The agent gave us the money to buy the bot we need from the gang. By choosing to call the Militech agent early, we have now opened up a non-violent path through this quest. Of course, we could try and keep the money, but that would mean we'd have to take the merchandise by force, which requires a lot of firepower.
Looked a little fishy, you know, people tense. No signal, so I stay put.
Good thing, too. Went down about like I expected. Made a deal, and we're good to meet with Maelstrom now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I might pick this up.
Be there
nice.
Soon. What do you expect?
Corpse don't forgive or forget.
Game Boy, you still there, buddy?
Borg fuck sense that. Feel the pressure. That's why they're holed up in this shithole, praying to the almighty Trip Six. Gotta move the tech, but they can't. Cause your new best friend from the tripped out, tanked out SUV is just begging them to try. How you wanna do this?
Even now, we can choose how to approach this quest. Do we go in guns blazing, or do we try to negotiate
all right,
for the bomb?
Plan's simple. We pay with the Corpo's cred and get out.
I don't know, but you're calling this one.
For this demo, let's try the more diplomatic approach.
Tough shit. All we need's for them to buy it.
Don't know you.
Yeah.
Wanna talk to Royce.
Main room. I'm waiting.
All strapped with Militech gear.
Psycho Borg, chromed out with military-grade hardware worth millions. Should be
the guys we're about to meet are dangerous. They are members of the Maelstrom gang, and their obsession with body modification goes way beyond even this world's standards. On their path to becoming machines, they don't shy away from even the most extreme measures.
Anti-personnel mine. Shrapnel's better. My favorite.
Gangoons getting creative with their gear.
It looks like they made this abandoned All Foods meat factory their hideout. Charming.
Another one? Seriously?
Maybe we should have taken him by surprise.
A little late for regress like that. Got us in their sights now. Just keep moving. Stay cool. They're just trying to spook us.
Remember, we've chosen to buy the tech, not steal it. Hopefully this will go fast and easy. This is a pretty
get in the elevator,
place.
You fucking sheep.
Imagine what would have happened if we'd taken the violent path.
I might take the violent path in this game.
What?
Looking to buy a bot. Model MTOD-12. Looks like a spider.
Couch planted. Yo, Kerr. Peek around the corner, see if we got anything like that. Well, shit. Sit down.
Okay. Shocker.
Can't move on your culo. Makes you an easy target.
Sit down.
I like a challenge.
That really necessary, hombre?
I ain't your
That's
hombre.
Why I don't play as a killer in Dead by Daylight.
Sit your ass down before I plant a bullet in your skull.
Jack, sit down.
This ain't gonna end well.
Shit. Well, all right, fucking bravo. Come on, lighten up. Have a whiff. Better. Now we can talk.
The bot. Need to see it.
Suit yourself. Fucking tricked out, state-of-the-art this thing. Don't even got no standard port. Bells and whistles, though, dynamic camo armor and motor impulses rivaling that of the human nervous system. Its actuators are actually pimped with titanium fiber, and it can go anywhere, literally. Watch this.
It's fucking scary because they do have bots like that. Not this sophisticated, but yeah.
You could lose your lunch. So, what you think?
Hey, up and let's get the fuck out of here.
The bot. I'll take it.
Puppy bot.
Two
yeah.
questions. What the fuck's going on? And who the fuck is this?
Got 50 large on this creature.
And you positively reek of Militech.
Dexter Deshawn sent me.
Dexter Deshawn. Dreads. Gold plate. Fat old fuck. That him?
Oh ho!
We'll pay for the bot. We'll be on our way.
How much you say you had? 50k?
Fred's on this.
Move it.
Woo, not the smoothest of deals, but it worked out in the end, right? Flathead's good gear. It'll do the trick. Whatever that trick is.
Shit.
Shit, shit, shit!
It turns out the cred chip we got from the Militech agent contained a virus which fried their system. Royce, their leader, is making a break for it.
Had to end this way.
Before we figure out a way to leave, let's grab the splinter that controls the bot from one of these dead maelstromers.
I want the robo puppy. Well, they have them out there. You can buy them.
Take a closer look at the splinter. You can inspect specific items to reveal details that can help in solving quests. Okay, let's equip the splinter to our chipware slot. With this done, the bot will now follow us wherever we go. All right, what else do we have here? Nice. A street-modified tech shotgun. Tech weapons fire rounds that penetrate walls and other types of cover. They also have an alternate fire mode that allows you to power up shots and deal more damage. It looks like there are several ways out of this room, like those gates, for example. However, you'd have to be a skilled netrunner to hack into this terminal. Luckily, our engineering skills should allow us to disassemble that maintenance panel so we can get
through the door. Yeah, the puppy, Hangry, and Meep would be so happy. What the fuck? In the game oh, a free puppy. Gotcha.
The engineering skill can be used to fix, disassemble, and disarm devices blocking
production
your
line passes through here.
And we're gonna pass through with it.
So, from this point on, we're going to unlock the abilities of a high-end character to showcase some of the different mechanics we have in the game. One of the new weapon modules we now have installed is a ricochet targeting system connected to our eyes. This allows players to bounce bullets off walls and hit enemies hiding behind cover.
Yeah.
This is another targeting system that will reveal enemies behind walls. Paired with the penetrating...
Watch this. Shotgun, boom.
It's a deadly combination.
His fucking legs.
We found some loot.
This is an oversized nail gun.
This is a smart gun. It's one of the more advanced weapons in the game, allowing bullets to track and follow.
Look at this thing.
It's one of many different weapons players can acquire. Weapons are built of modules that allow for deep customization and progression. This way, you can be sure to find something that will suit your playstyle.
The toughest bastards guarding this route. Probably some reason for that.
Boing! Boing! And legs again! His head off, he was still talking about his legs.
Just a reminder, everything you've seen and are about to see, including this particular feature we're about to show you, is from a work-in-progress version of the game and may change over the course of development.
Okay,
let's try something different. We're going to take this guy down and connect directly to his neural side. In the world of Cyberpunk, once you are jacked into a network, you have access to everything it connects to. Through this Maelstrom gang member, we've now connected to the gang hideout's internal network. This is the building's personnel system. Let's focus on the squad containing the Maelstrom ganger we just connected to. From here, we can deploy software that affects the whole squad. For now, we'll simply unlock the ability to perform quick hacks. All right, time to show off our new high-level abilities. With Quick Hack, using the backdoor we unlocked a minute ago, we'll install a virus that jams the connection between the Maelstrom ganger and his weapon. This will prevent him from firing.
What the hell is...
Looks like he's having a problem now. Nice. Some of you might recognize these mantis blades. We can also double jump and bounce off of walls, which makes us a very agile, fast solo.
Sneaky, I like it. Yeah, there's a lot you can do with this game.
I'll check down here.
Sweet, we just found a corporate tech.
I just wish you could actually go top of the line. Pull the weapon out of the case and actually do it. Instead of just
let's scan this guy and see what's
going on.
It looks like
and you don't actually
back.
See grabbing it.
He's got an armored exoskeleton. We won't be able to get rid of him that easily. Our weapons are not dealing a lot of damage because he's packing an autonomous shield. Luckily,
I need to touch all the buttons.
Attacking should bring the shield down.
Oh my god, this is a fucking amazing game. Woo! And but now
shields down. Let's finish him off.
Boy, it ain't going your way, you cunts.
Okay, let's put him down and get this job over.
He
that
is
wasn't
poop
the smoothest raid, but we've got the bot, and Dex should be happy. But think back. What would have happened if we hadn't met with the Militech agent? Or told Royce about the agent and her plans. Or just decided to buy the bot ourselves.
Like,
so many options. So many possibilities.
This is just a single player, man. The fucking multiplayer. Oh.
It will ripple through the game world and your story. And that's just one quest. Let's head out and finish the job.
About goddamn time. Let's get out of here.
Hey, Flurry. The fucking night shot right there, man. The neon, the lights.
You know, we really ought to work together more often.
Yeah.
Your chip had the clap. That's not
the chip had the clap. Had STD.
I fucked you over. You fucked the gang over. Somewhere at the start of
we'll
the
we'll both
story,
fuck each other.
Somebody fucked the corp. See how this works now? Only the corp gets what it wants. Remember that. Learn it. Years down the line, you'll be standing where I am, watching somebody else doing.
Yep, being a raging bitch to whoever's doing my dirty work for me.
It's time we were on our way, Ida.
Okay, let's call Dex and tell him how things went down.
My girl, shit-eating suits. Mama knows.
Hey, Mr. Dex. Get us that table at the afterlife?
Matter of fact, I did. Just in my gut and all, you know.
Well, you were right, too.
Well done, Missy. Well done. See you there.
Street cred level 2?
Shit, I can't believe it, Ina. Major leagues. We're in. I mean, we fucking pried the door open.
But the only thing I want to pry open right now is a bottle of scotch.
Oh, no. Not another three-nighter. Por favor.
Three-nighter.
Need to get to know this city, Jack. Not just gun in hand. I want a crusade.
Amen, I know.
We finished the job. But our story is just beginning. This concludes our gameplay demo walk. Thanks for watching.
That is just, that was like second time.
And that is Cyberpunk 2077. Ooh. That's the full gameplay reveal. I'm Max Scoville from IGN.
Butts.
This is Tom Marks with me.
No, you forgot about the boobage you saw earlier in the game.
To see Cyberpunk day one of E3.
Yeah.
And we came out and we enthusiastically pointed everyone in that direction to go check it out.
Uh-huh.
Was that pretty much the exact same thing we saw?
That was, as far as I could tell, the exact same demo that we saw at E3. I know the Gamescom demo was a little bit different, but this was pretty much exactly what we saw. And I'm so glad the world has seen it now.
It's really nice to finally, because we came out, we're all excited. We actually had one of IGN's very own John Ryan was over in Germany for Gamescom and got to speak to some guys from CD Projekt Red. We have an interview with them that we'll put up after we gush about Cyberpunk for a minute. So yeah, let's talk
gotta
about this.
Refresh
something I really want to go into. First of all,
yeah.
All right. Sorry, I just had to do it because the audio was off a little bit. We still got. Okay.
Give us the money to buy the bot we need.
Oh, okay. For some reason, it started all the way back here. Well, anyway, that was Cyberpunk. Not really anyone popped in except you guys. Gold and Game Boy. And Flurry was in here for a little bit, but he left already. But if anyone did enjoy that's not a regular, hit that follow button and join the nation. It would mean so much to me. And definitely will be playing this game when it does come out, whenever. I still don't know. It could be next year. It could be 2020, could be 2021. My bet is 2020, but yeah. All right. I will catch you guys later. I do appreciate everyone tuning in. I'll be streaming later today, probably some more Dead by Daylight. New Killer is out tomorrow. I have to figure out how to implement that in my game files, and it allows me to play on the test server or whatever server it is, the beta. But I will talk to you guys later, and thank you once again for tuning into the nation.